KTLA is proud to partner with Raise a Child, a nonprofit organization dedicated to building loving families for foster children.
And today we're celebrating Father's Day a little early with a special family. Joining us via Skype, foster and adoptive dads Hector and Steven Ramirez Robles and Elizabeth Gonzalez, the Chief Program Officer of Child Care Agency 5 Acres. So thank you guys all for joining us today.
Thank you.
Of course. So Elizabeth, 5 Acres has a rich history here in Southern California. Explain how the COVID-19 pandemic has impacted the need for both foster and adoptive parents.
Yeah, since our beginnings as an orphanage in 1888, 5 Acres has been committed to strengthening children and families and empowering them within their communities. We have a continuum of services, and two of those services are our foster care program and our adoption support services. And to answer your question about COVID, although we don't know what the full impact will be to our foster care system, what we do know is that there are 28,000 foster children in LA County, and the need for foster adopt families was great prior to COVID, and it will be after as well.
So Elizabeth, Hector and Steven are a 5 Acres foster and adoptive family. Can you tell us about them and how you guys met up?
Yeah, so Steven and Hector are two of our amazing foster adopt dads. They've been with 5 Acres since 2015, and since then they've adopted two adorable boys, and they are currently fostering 3 children.
Wow. So Steven, how did you know foster parenting was the right path for you and Hector?
Oh, shoot. You know, being a gay man, I always knew that I wanted a family. So, and didn't know how that was going to happen. So we came across, you know, Raise a Child that led us to 5 Acres. And through them, you know, they made us a family.
Oh, I'm so happy for you guys. And Hector, many prospective foster and adoptive parents worry about loving a child in their care and then the child reunifying with their birth family. Have you experienced those concerns, and how do you handle them?
Yes, we have actually. We actually had our oldest, who was with us for several years, reunify with family out of state last summer. And it's difficult. It's something that was difficult for us. It was difficult for the boys, difficult for our extended family, grandma, grandpa, everybody. But at the end of the day, you kind of just have to take solace in knowing that in the time they were with you, you were able to show them love. You were able to give them a sense of belonging. And, you know, you hope that that sticks with them, you know, after they go.
And I'm sure they'll always be part of your family. So, Elizabeth, a question for you. What qualities make a good foster or adoptive parent?
So Raise a Child and 5 Acres welcome a diverse population of prospective parents. You know, there's no real such thing as a typical foster adopt family. But the two main things that we're looking for is families or individuals that are willing to open their heart and provide a safe and loving home for a child. So if anyone is interested, take that next step, because there are a lot of children out there that are awaiting a home.
Yeah. And finally, Steven and Hector, how do you guys plan to celebrate Father's Day with your kids?
Here at home. You know, we can't go anywhere else.
Good old fashioned barbecue.
You know, just hanging out outside, probably barbecue some hot dogs for the boys, and I don't know, maybe let them go swimming.
Enjoy some family time.
Yeah.
Make them clean up after you. That's your Father's Day present. How's that?
Right. Go.
Well, thank you guys so much for joining us today. And for more information about becoming a foster or adoptive parent, or to learn about ways you can support Raise a Child, head to raiseachild.org, or you can email info@raiseachild.org. You see all that information on your screen. Thanks again, you guys.
They're angels. So great to see that.